Hey YouTube community, it is I, Brad, coming to you live from my apartment, which at the moment is quite dirty. Give me a second here, popping on some musics. Let's see, what do we got going on? Got some music in the background, some good stuff. So, I'm smoking today a Harcourt, little doojobby, I think. This is the one that we don't know the name of. One of my grandfather's pipes here. And it's time I do a tobacco review. And today I picked up this giant tub of Carter Hall. And I'll read you on the back what it says. Since 1856, we at John Middleton Company have dedicated our resources to producing one-of-a-kind quality pipe tobacco brands at affordable prices. Our commitment is to meet the personal smoking preferences of all our customers. The unique blend of Carter Hall pipe tobacco is achieved by adhering to the very high standards we set in every step of production. The attention and care paid to selecting and curing our tobacco equals that of blending and finishing. As a result, Middleton Pipe Tobacco brands provide superior consistency, ensuring your smoking pleasure every time. No name products would compromise these tough standards that we would reduce your that would reduce your smoking pleasure. Middleton Pipe Tobacco brands are your best assurance of value, quality, and value. I have smoked a few bowls of this. It is decent. In the tin, you get a burley Virginia and raisin prune notes, which I think are quite nice. There's a little bit of nuttiness to it. A little bit of honey in there as well, maybe mixed in. Maybe a little hazelnut. Then I find hazelnut honey tends to lend itself with the Virginias in here. Or with any Virginia, tends to lend itself a little bit to sort of a raisiny kind of, addition. It's like mixing colors, mixing smells can create another smell. Yeah, it's nice. Maybe a little chocolate in there as well. So let me load up here, and we'll get to the lighting. So packing this tobacco, it's a fairly loose and pretty standard over-the-counter cut, if you can tell in there, okay. I don't know how well that's focusing in there, but if you can kind of tell, it's sort of like broken leaf. Not really any crumble cake in here, or any kind of pressed tobacco. A couple stems and different things like that, some veins, some thicker parts of the leaf are in here. But that's to be expected, in my opinion, with a value brand or a value OTC. But I gotta say, for an OTC, this is not half bad. But I don't want to get into reviewing this tobacco until I've lit up a bowl, because this is a trial in a brand new pipe. Well, not a brand new pipe, a very old but new pipe. So, very nice. Okay, here we go. My pack was a gravity feed into this pipe. Easy draw, not too bad. Okay, off the bat I can already tell that you really don't need to light this that much. It's a pretty good light on its own. Very well lit inside of the packaging. Or I should say, I said that wrong. Lights very well off the bat. When it comes out of the packaging, it's not very dry, so it's easy to light. Or not very wet, I should say. Wow, I'm really screwing this up. Okay. I definitely get the nuttiness coming in from the cube burley. That's what I'm going to assume the burley is, a cube cut of some kind. So right on the first light, really nice. Tiny bit of soap in there. But it ain't overpowering. It's something you really have to search for. The burley definitely comes through with a nuttiness. There is a sweeter flavor and a higher note in there, which is nice. Especially on the retrohale coming through the nose, I get a bit of that. Casings are light, not very detectable. It's a nice, light, easy smoke. Definitely something, if you don't want to spend the 30 or 40 bucks on a nice 14-ounce tub, you can certainly go out. And this actually feels like more than 14 ounces of tobacco. There's a lot of tobacco in here. Bit of bite on the taper on the end of the draw, but nothing overly egregious. But I do say that straight out of this tin, what's on top that I'm going to be packing first was not too wet. It was definitely ready to go into my pipe, which is nice. In the bowl, it smokes a little bit warm, but the there's really very minimal bite. The burley in here is really nice. Nick Kick, yeah, I give it a 4 out of 10. Somewhere between a 4 and a 6 out of 10. I would equate it to a slightly stronger McBaron aromatic if you've got an empty stomach. Tobacco you want to pack not too tightly. You don't want a lot of smoke getting trapped inside of your bowl. It will bite. This bowl is pretty wide, and it's got a nice big chamber inside the shank, so it's very easy drawing pipe. So, you know, something that's not, you know, very little effort gets you quite a lot of draw. Something I would recommend you pack into.
Suppose that instead of auto races starting with, "Gentlemen, start your engines," the announcer says, "Guys, step on the pedal on the right."
I get a little bit of earthiness, a little bit of leafiness.
Right. Whether you're starting a race,
you know, sort of like autumn leaves. I don't know if you can equate to that at all. But guys, you know, definitely a good smoke, something to try. I would definitely pick it up in a small pouch before you try it in a large tin. I picked it up in a large tin, and I'm definitely going to be mixing this with something else. Maybe put some Latakia in here, maybe some different Virginias, and try to spice things up a bit. Maybe a few casings or two, just to play around with what we got going on inside the bowl. But guys, Carter Hall out of 10, and 10 I would consider to be my longtime steady smokes for this kind of a thing. So something by Cornell and Deal GLPs, I'm going to give it about a 6.
After I'm gone, your Earth will be free to live out its miserable span of existence. It's one of my satellites. And that's how it's going to be.
If you'd like a few samples of this, I'd be more than willing to send you an ounce or two. Just PM me your information and I'll get some out to you. Guys, this has been a review of Carter Hall. I do recommend that you give it a shot. As an over-the-counter blend, you really can't go wrong with this stuff. Captain Black, yeah, stay away. This is a definitely decent blend. Reminds me a little bit of Sir Walter Raleigh. Or Prince Albert, I should say. It's not a straight burley. There's a little more Virginia in there. A little bit more of a casing. But guys, definitely worth your time in trying. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy. Good luck.